الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن نبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، أوصيكم ونفسي المقصرة بتقوى الله، وأحذركم وأحذر نفسي من عصيان الخالق ومخالفة أمره. أما بعد، أيها المسلمون عباد الله، praise الله سبحانه وتعالى and send more blessings about his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his guidance from the day that we reached puberty till the day that we leave from this world. Alhamdulillah, by the grace of Allah, Ramadan has come to an end. But to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a lifetime duty for every believer. For every believer, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a lifetime duty for every Muslim. If Ramadan disappeared and finished, the ibadah of Rabbil Alameen is our obligation. يقول الله تبارك وتعالى وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. Indeed, I did not create mankind as jinn except that they worship me. And to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a blessing. It doesn't have a time. It doesn't have a time. In that time that we come to the masjid and we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we go back to our old bad habits. It's not that way. We have to understand that Allah created us for an objective, which is to worship Him Jalla fi Ulah. The masajid in Ramadan were fully packed. Everybody was trying to have his place in the masjid. Both men and women were reading Quran. We were fasting. We were giving charity. We were praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There was tahajjud in the late night for Muslims. And everyone was rushing to catch up his place in the masjid so he can pray tarawih. It was a great month that we all missed. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Lord of the year. He is the Lord of every month and every month and every week and every month and every minute of our life. We have to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to continue coming to the masjid. We have to still read the Quran. We have to still give charity. قال حسن البصري رحمه الله تعالى ليس للعمل المؤمن وقت دون الموت. He said the deeds of the believer doesn't have a time until death comes to him. ويقول الله تبارك وتعالى في محكم تنزيله وهو أصدق القائلين واعبد ربك حتى يأتيك اليقين. Allah said to this to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And we are included with that. So Allah said subhanahu wa ta'ala, worship your Lord until yaqeen comes to you. ما هو اليقين? What is the yaqeen? The scholars, they said, yaqeen, al-maut, is the death. Until death comes to you, you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till we depart from this world and we end up in that tiny hole which we call the grave. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran while he is talking about the salah, subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us so many verses in the Quran and tells us وَرْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ وَاسْجُدُوا مَعَ السَّاجِدِينَ. Make rukuh with those who are making rukuh. And prostrate with those who prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا. صلاة is something which is prescribed on the believers. How can a Muslim live without a صلاة? The صلاة is the basic thing that we do. So after Ramadan, we should not abandon the salah. We should not stop and coming to the masjid and standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say to them, tell them that my salah, wa nusuki, and my sacrifice, wa mahyaya wa mamati, and my living and my death, lillahi rabbil alameen, belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We all belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So our salah and our sacrifice and our life and death belong to him. Jalla fi ulah. It belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa yaqul Umar al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, la hadha fi al-islam liman taraka as-salah. Allahu akbar. Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, la hadha fi al-islam liman taraka as-salah. He has no a lack or any chance in Islam whoever abandons the salah. Some Muslims were misguided by the shaitan. So you see them, I know some people who only pray only Friday. They pray only the khutbah time, only that salah. He will pray Fajr, he will just come to the masjid, put on some khamis, He will come to the masjid and pray the Jum'ah and listen to the Khatib. Then he will not pray Asr, not Maghrib, not Isha. So he is a weekly Muslim, part-time Muslim and weekly Muslim. You only see him in the masjid only Friday. Subhanallah. And some other Muslims, they only pray and come to the masjid only Ramadan. وقال بعض السلف رضوان الله عليهم بئس القوم الذين لا يعرفون الله عز وجل إلا في رمضان. The worst people are those who only know Allah سبحانه وتعالى in Ramadan. Allah سبحانه وتعالى is the Lord of the year and the months and the week and every time and minute. So we have to worship Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وعن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قلت يا رسول الله أي العمل أعظم عند الله؟ عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه said I said to the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم what is the greatest deed in Islam? قال الصلاة على وقتها. The messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said the greatest deed in Islam is offering salah on its time. And this hadith narrated by Bukhari and Muslim. The greatest deed in Islam is the salah on time. وقد توعد الله عز وجل لمن يؤخرون الصلاة بالنار فكيف بمن تركها كلية فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون. Allah intimidated those who delay their salah. الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون. Those who are unaware of their salah and they delay it intentionally. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intimidated them with the hellfire. Move forward. جزاكم الله خير. Love of plastic fire with hellfire. جزاكم الله خير. Move forward. Don't come here. All is empty. جزاكم الله خير. So Allah intimidated those who are praying but delaying their salah. كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم when he was explaining the signs of the منافق قال عليه الصلاة والسلام تلك صلاة المنافق يرغب الشمس حتى إذا كانت بين قرن الشيطان قام فنقر أربعا. الله أكبر. The messenger of Allah said the منافق, that is the salah of the hypocrite and the منافق. He will stare at the sun when the sun is between the two horns of the shaitan. قام فنقر أربعا. He stands up and he quickly, like a crow, he breaks like that. That is the salah of the munafiq. What about the one? I know one, he died when he was like 83 years old. Muslim. He said at his death time, he said, what will I say to Allah? I never made a wudu in my life. And I never put my feet into a masjid in my life. And I never made sujood in my life. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. And then he died. He died without salah, without wudu, without istighfar, without reciting the Quran, without having no connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah blessed him with 83 years. The salah, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول أرحنا يا بلال أرحنا يا بلال. The Messenger of Allah said to Bilal, make the adhan and let us enjoy it. The salah is the best enjoyment that we can ever taste. The salah is the sweetest thing that I have ever tasted and you have ever tasted. تنادي ربك. You have conversation with your Lord, with your creator and sustainer and jarisha who provided everything to you. One brother said, Muslim brother, he said, I was in this array. I was in depression. And I could not cope with it. Then I decided to kill myself and end myself. He said, when I went into the toilet and there was a rock, I was planning to hang myself. He said, some brothers knocked the door of my toilet. They came after me and they said, they give me da'wah. They took me to the masjid. And then he said, by Allah, when I took shower and made wudu, I put my forehead for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all this hardship and difficult and depression was completely lifted from me. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ. Seek help with بالصبر والصلاة, with patience and salah. And Allah says in the Quran, فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ, run to Allah. Whenever you are in difficulty, say, يا رحمن, يا رحيم, يا عزيز, يا جبار. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah will help you. So we have to, we should not be Ramadaniyun, those who only worship Allah in Ramadan, but we have to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He wants us to worship Him. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب وخطيئة فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين على أمور الدنيا والدين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. وبعد, الله سر القرآن ولا تكونوا كالتي نقضت غزلها من بعد قوة أنكافا. It's a beautiful example in the Quran which Allah has given to us. There was a woman in Mecca. She was mentally ill, and she would make a mat early in the morning. She will make it a very long mat. She will decorate it and make it very beautiful. But before the sun sets, she will dismantle it, like she has never done anything. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us that example in the Quran. And he said, do not be like the woman who will make her man strong. And then she will undo it. Some Muslims, alhamdulillah, in Ramadan, they gave up smoking. But some of them, unfortunately, went back after the Eid, for example. After the Eid, some started smoking again. Some they became lazy, they don't come to the masjid. So, what happened to all your energy and your ability? What happened to you? So the salah, especially we have to focus on our salah. حافظوا على الصلوات والصلاة الوسطى وقوموا لله قانتين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, حافظوا على الصلوات والصلاة الوسطى. Keep your salah. And صلاة الوسطى is صلاة العصر. وقوموا لله قانتين. And stand up for Allah while you are humble. Salah. يقول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام والحديث في صحيح الجامع كلما إذا قام العبد يصلي ووضع ذنوبه على رأسه وعلى عاتقه فكلما ركع أو سجد تساقط عنه الله أكبر. So the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, when the servant of Allah stands in salah, all his sins are put on his head and on his shoulders. And whenever he goes in ruku' and sujood, they fall off. All your sins will fall off from your body. How can you miss that salah then? ويقول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام الصلاة نور والصبر ضياء وصدقة برهان والقرآن حجة لك أو عليك. Which means الصلاة نور. صلاة is a light. You see the true believers who constantly pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have a light, glowing face. They have a nur, a light on their faces. وَصَبْرُ ضِيَاءَ. And the patience is lightning, it's a light. وَصَدَقَةُ burhan, and the charity is a power, is evidence for the one who is giving it that he has sincerity. وَالْقُرْآنُ حُجَّةٌ لَكَ أَوْ عَلَيْكَ. And the Quran will be a witness for you on the day of judgment. If you acted about it and you live on the Quran, أو عليك, or the Quran will go against you and will testify against you if you do not live above the Quran and you do not act above the Quran. يقول الله عز وجل إنه لذكر لك ولقومك وسوف تسألون. Indeed the Quran, it's a dignity for you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and for those who follow you. So the Quran, يقول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام: القرآن والصيام يأتيان يوم القيامة يشفعان لصاحبهما. On the day of resurrection, the day of judgment, when we are all resurrected and we move and stand in front of Allah, the Quran will make shafa'a, intercession. The Quran will intercede for those who used to recite. And the fasting will also intercede for those who were fasting. يقول القرآن: أي منعته يا ربي من النوم فشفعني فيه. Oh Allah, I forbid him from sleeping. Let me intercede him. If you never open the Quran, if you never have any connection with the Quran will say bye-bye to you on the day of judgment. Because you never open it. I know their family, subhanAllah, they shifted from their house. They took everything, even the needles, everything they took, and they left the Quran on the floor. أعوذ بالله. This is our situation with the Quran. يا رب إن قومي اتخذوا القرآن مهجورا. The messenger is crying and he says, Oh my Lord, my people have abandoned the Quran. يقول النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام: إن لله أهلا. Allah has got a family. Who are the family of Allah? أهل القرآن أهل الله وخاصته. The people of the Quran are the family of Allah and they are so special to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. So let us improve our relationship with the Quran. Let us recite the Quran. Every word of the Quran, when you recite, you are blessed. And the Quran will make shafa'a for you on the day of judgment and take you to the Jannah. So, let us be Muslims forever. We have to be a Muslim forever. We have to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forever. So we can go to Jannah with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companion and the righteous people. And we should not go back to Jahiliyyah. We have to practice our deen. And we never know when death will come to us. والموت يأتي بغتة والقبر صندوق العمل. Death comes unexpectedly. How many young boys die? How many teenagers have? We buried and put them in the grave. So we have to be Muslim for every time and every minute of our life. We have to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the last one, وعلى ما أيها الأنسان رضي الله عنه قال قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه ستة من شوال كان كصيام الدهر. رواه مسلم في صحيحه. So the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever fasts the holy month of Ramadan and follows up with 6 more days of fasting will be like someone who has fasted the whole year. So let us not forget to fast Shawwal, inshallah. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين، اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر المسلمين في فلسطين، اللهم انصر المسلمين في مسجد الاقصى المبارك يا رب العالمين، اللهم انصر المسلمين في غزه يا رب العالمين، غزه الابيه يا رب العالمين، اللهم انصرهم نصرك المؤزر المبين لاوليائك في كل مكان يا رب العالمين، اللهم انصر المسلمين في كشمير وفي تشاينا يا رب العالمين، وفي الهند وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى يا من له الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة في الدوس الأعلى يا رب العالمين مع الأبرار يا رب العالمين. وأقم السلام.